Kia ora. I'm Jackie Tuara. I am a choreographer for Whakapākitimu cultural team. I actually come from two tribes, from Makea in Te Awatonga and from Tahitian. My greatest passion in life will have to be Cook Islands dance. I have danced for as long as I know, probably from the moment I could walk. Enjoying being part of family celebrations, being part of school celebrations, and just enjoying being who I am and where I come from. I think within us is an innate sense of culture and heritage, especially for us here in the Cook Islands, and I think in the Pacific as a whole. Growing up, I danced with the Taikoka dance team, and as I got older, my passion for dance developed into an interest for choreography. And so I have, over the last, I don't know, maybe 15 years or so, that has become a large part of my culture or my part in Cook Islands culture. I have choreographed items for Whakatakitimu dance team. I have choreographed items for contestants joining competitions, dance competitions, pageants, Miss South Pacific pageant, Miss Cook Islands pageant, Miss Te Aru pageant. I guess that stems, the choreography stems from my interest in creating something out of our traditions or out of our culture and my view of what I think it is or what I have grown up to believe that it is. My passion for dance began many years ago as a little girl. I have always enjoyed Cook Islands dance. It has been my passion for many years through school, through cultural dance teams. And growing up, it has instilled within me the foundations of who I am, where I come from, and the importance of our cultural heritage. Today, I play a big role in choreographing for Whakatakitimu dance team. We took part into Mai Vanui this year, 2013, being absent for 5 years. So the challenge was to, for me this year, was basically to regroup Tahitian, to bring back the spirit that we felt in 2007, which somewhere along the line, I don't know whether we lost it or we just went through a period of maybe trying to understand where we are and where we're moving to. For me, the importance in culture, the importance in choreography, the importance for dance is to pass that passion on to the next generation. Without culture, without tradition, without heritage, we don't really understand or we will never feel a belonging to a place, to the land, to the sea, to our country. And to instill that passion into the next generation to keep it going, for them to build that passion within themselves and pass it on to the next generation is what inspires me. And to see the enjoyment grow when you're working with a team to put together performances, bring alive stories about their culture, to bring alive drum beats that just, what can I say, just makes your pulse race, is what passion for culture is about for me. And to pass that on to the next generation is what I really want to do. So much has to happen, so much has to come together, so much understanding and so much trust needs to happen in order for everything to work. And working with so many personalities is an obstacle. Trying to relay to others your ideas, your vision, and what you see. I think the way that we have overcome that obstacle or those many obstacles is that I have been very fortunate and humble that people have trust in me to make this happen, to help them make this happen. And that's the only way it can happen, is that you, if you have the trust in the person that's doing this for everybody. The other obstacles are, of course, lack of sleep, making costumes, you're up all night, early hours of the morning. Finance can also be an obstacle, but we find ways to work through that. And the best thing that we've discovered this year is to go back to using natural materials, saving costs there. But it's also made our costumes more traditional, more natural, more us, and that's what I feel. The feeling leading up to the night of performance is one, I guess, of nervousness. This year for Wakatakitumu, we had a whole lot of new dancers who have never ever stepped onto the stage at the National Auditorium. So obviously, just before stepping on that stage, they're hyped up but very nervous at the same time. In the changing room, you could feel that nervous energy. And so as a choreographer, who's danced many times, who's been on stage many times, I absolutely knew and felt what they were feeling. And I knew that if they had the mental strength to carry it on, because they could certainly perform it, they would just be ecstatic at the end. And they were. They did a wonderful performance, and as soon as the lights go out at the end of performance, they were jumping up on stage and high-fiving each other. It was just wonderful. That's great. So yeah, there are many obstacles, but the hard work, the commitment, the late nights, the tiredness, all that is worth something at the end when it happens, when your performance is on stage, when everyone is hyped up and they've felt they've done a great job, then all that is certainly worth it. Te Mai Vanui doesn't happen overnight. It doesn't happen within a week. It takes months of preparation to get to the stage where you're on stage and you're doing a 7-minute performance. It begins with calling your waka or your tribe together and deciding whether or not you're going to take part in Te Mai Vanui for this year. Once a decision has been made, practice starts. It's a slow process to get everyone there because everyone knows, well, Te Mai Vanui is a couple of months away, so some sit back and wait. The really keen ones are there at practice, but you work with them. You start to form your ideas. Every year there is a theme that's set for each Te Mai Vanui, so you form your ideas, you form your stories, you form your performances around the theme for the year. That might take a little while as well, but as you're working with that, dancers are working on their dancing skills for maybe the first couple of weeks. We work with singers, songwriters, to put together our performances, with drummers to put together drum dances, then drumming sequences, and all that might take a month before it's finalized. But as we get each part or each item done, we start to choreograph and teaching that. Collecting things that we need, maybe seeds from various trees, or going up inland and cutting down what we call a wild hibiscus bark that we scrape, we put that into the water, we leave it in the water for a couple of weeks, we clean it, we bring it out, we dry it, and that's what we use for our skirts, and lots of other things like that. We might collect shells, we might polish shells, or a lot of work goes into costume preparation, and a lot of thought goes into what we should use for costumes as well. Costumes may also mean fresh costumes which we would make the night or two before. It might include leaves that we collect from various plants. So the whole process cannot just happen in a week, really. It does take months from practices and costume making. The week leading up to the final nights, most costumes will be done. The choreography for every item is probably 95% done. A lot of the final parts of a performance are done within the week that we're competing. And all of that takes a lot of time. The nights before, we're up until the early hours just putting final touches to costumes. For me, a future without culture would be the end of my tradition, of my culture as I know it. In this modern world, it seems that culture is no longer important. Many say, well, what use is culture? We don't need culture. We need to live in this modern world. Well, I say, without culture, you have no foundation. You have no sense of belonging to a country. You have no sense of belonging to a land. Those are the important things to me about culture. It is more than being able to live in this modern society. I believe that we can all live in this modern society with our culture. It is part of us. It will always be a part of us. It makes us who we are. It gives us an innate sense of belonging somewhere. No matter where we are in the world, halfway across the world, in Russia, in London, each time we hear those drums, each time we hear Māori words spoken, each time we hear Māori songs being sung. So we do need to pass that on. We do need to pass on our culture, our traditions, and what it is to be a Cook Islands person. Culture has a voice. We are that voice. We have a chant in Takitumu. E reo, tō te kāara. E reo, tō te pau. E reo, a ka teni teni. E reo, tā iwa iwa ki te piri ārangi. E reo, tō te kapa, te mana o te peo ura. E mana me tū manawa. Oh, cut. See, I have to remember that.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Wakataketumu cultural dance team has a pe'e, or chant, that goes, E reo, tō te kāara. E reo, tō te pau. E reo, a ka teni teni. E reo, tā iwa iwa ki te piri ārangi. E reo, tō te kapa. Te mana o te peo ura. E reo, mei te manawa. Ko wau, te ngutu are. Ko wau, te ngutu are. Taku peo Māori e, kia ora. And what that chant means is our drums have a voice. Our kāara, or wooden drums, have a voice. Our skin drums have a voice. Their voice is harmonious and reaches the layers of the heavens. Our actions have a voice, and those actions are within the prestige or mana of our dance. And those voices are within us, for we are the home within which they are housed. So our culture, our pū Māori,